In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of mastication muscles. Mastication means movement of chewing. I will explain four muscles. In first picture, I will explain two muscles. First muscle is this one, this broad muscle. This is temporalis. Temporalis, this is very broad muscle. Its origin is temporal line, which is about here. Origin is temporal line. By the way, this muscle is across many bones, such as here, frontal bone, here, parietal, and here, temporal bone. By the way, that's why this is temporalis. And deep to about this area, there's such an important bone that is sphenoid. See, this muscle is across many bones. That means when temporalis gets tight, that can affect these four bones. That's very important. By the way, this is origin. Insertion is about deep to this level. There is a tiny bony bump around here that is coronoid process. Coronoid process. This is important bony landmark. Then, what is function of temporalis? When temporalis contracts, that brings mandible this way. What is this movement? This is elevation. This movement creates chewing movement. That makes sense. I want you to focus on the direction of temporalis. It is not only vertical. It's kind of diagonal and it's kind of horizontal. So what happens if horizontal fiber contracts this way? That can bring your mandible to posterior direction. This movement is retraction. Retraction is you bring your jaw to posteriorly. Okay, this is temporalis. Let's go to next one. Next muscle is this one. This is masseter. Masseter. There are two fibers. This is superficial fiber, and deep to that, this is deep fiber. Origin of masseter is little bit different, depends on fiber. So, superficial fiber attaches to this part. This part is zygomatic arch. Anterior two-thirds of zygomatic arch. So anterior two-thirds of zygomatic arch. Okay, this is superficial fiber. How about deep fiber? Deep fiber also attaches to zygomatic arch, but that is posterior one-third. Posterior one-third of zygomatic arch. So, these two fibers originate from zygomatic arch. Insertion is kind of simple. It's here. This is lateral surface of mandible. Lateral surface of mandible. What is function of masseter? That is elevation. Elevation. Plus, that can bring your mandible kind of this way. Look at the orientation of masseter. It's slightly diagonal, right? This diagonal muscle fiber can bring your mandible slightly anterior way. This is protrusion. Or some anatomy books might say protraction. Protrusion or protraction. Going back is retraction. Going front is protrusion or protraction. Okay, this is masseter. This is temporalis. This is masseter. These guys are slightly kind of a superficial muscles. Let's go to two deep muscles. Okay, first thing first, mandible is kind of a see-through, okay? Then I want to focus on these two deep muscles. Let me explain this guy first. This is medial pterygoid. Medial pterygoid. You do not pronounce it first letter of P, okay? This is medial pterygoid. Origin is upper part. Okay, this is origin of medial pterygoid. That is maxilla. Maxilla and lateral pterygoid plate. Lateral pterygoid plate. Oh my gosh, that's very busy name, right? That is origin. Insertion is here. This is medial surface of mandible. Let's say medial angle of mandible. Medial angle of mandible. Important thing is this is inside. Now, what is function? If this muscle contracts, that brings your mandible this way. That is elevation. Yeah, this is so important muscle. This is medial pterygoid. If there is medial, there should be lateral. Let's look at the last muscle. This is lateral pterygoid. Lateral pterygoid. Origin is this part. So these are like lateral pterygoid plate. Again. Lateral pterygoid plate and greater wing of sphenoid. Greater wing of sphenoid. Insertion is this part. Insertion is very unique. Actually, it attaches to joint capsule of TMJ. Joint capsule of temporomandibular joint, which is here. That means when this muscle gets tight, that can be one cause for temporomandibular joint dysfunction. This is such important for the joint of mandible. And one more insertion. That is mandible. About here. So this muscle attaches to bone and joint capsule. Very important for TMJ, temporomandibular joint dysfunction. So I explained four muscles today. Temporalis, masseter. This muscle has two fibers. Medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.